Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.5 Beta 2 has been out for a few days, and I've talked about a lot of its features, but there's even more new features that I'm going to cover in a moment, as well as the overall experience and what it's like to use. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, as well as the iPhone 11, iPhone 6S Plus, and also full-time on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. So the first thing is, let's talk about some of the features that are in this particular update that I didn't cover before. Now, I did mention one thing is that you can update over cellular, but this is specific to a region, it seems, specifically India at this point. All over the world, a lot of people want this feature, but in India particularly, a lot of people have been complaining about it and Apple has made it available. Generally, they don't do this at the request of carriers such as AT&T that doesn't want a million people updating and using their data and network at the same time with that much data. I hope they fix this in the future, but it's something that they haven't yet. Now, there's a couple things I missed in music specifically that they changed as well. So I showed you a couple of the different pop-up menus and things like that. And within the pop-up menu, you can see it says delete from library. This was not highlighted red before and just said remove. So now it's highlighted, kind of gives you a little bit of an extra caution there not to delete it if that's not what you want to do. So that's something that they've done as well. And then also, once you download an album, for example, you'll see we're downloading this one. We'll give it just a moment to finish downloading. It'll continue to download here. Give it just a moment. Once it's done, it will now give us a new icon, not only a check here, but also a little mark next to each song that lets us know that it's downloaded as well. So that's been updated as well. Just a couple nice little touches and a lot of new things within music. So not only is 14.5 looking to have a lot of little changes and sort of refinements in it, but also with being able to unlock your phone using a mask with Face ID and an Apple Watch, those things are really great. And I think we're going to see a lot more with 14.5 as time goes on. Now, another feature has to do with Game Center. Now, I'm not seeing this specifically on mine. Apparently, people have been saying there's a new splash screen the first time you open a game that uses Game Center. I wasn't able to reproduce this. I tried it on a couple different devices with different games I hadn't installed before, and I hadn't used Game Center before with Beta 2. It didn't pop up for me. So let me know if you're seeing that in the comments below. Now, with the iPad, there's a slight change as well, and that has to do with when you boot up the iPad logo or the Apple logo on the iPad works properly when you're using a Magic Keyboard with Beta 1, but with Beta 2, it will show up in the proper orientation based on how the iPad is oriented when you turn it on. Before, you had to have the Magic Keyboard attached. Now you can do it just by booting it up. So if I go ahead and restart it here, we'll go ahead and do this. We'll restart. We'll go ahead and turn it back on. See if it'll turn back on right away. There we go. And you'll see that it's in the correct orientation now. So it's a nice little change that they've made with this particular update. And another small change with the iPad has to do with Apple Pencil on this version. So if you go into settings and then you maybe go down to your pencil settings here, we'll go to Apple Pencil and you've got Scribble. Scribble now works with different languages as well. So if you're using Scribble, for example, to use handwriting, it will now work with additional languages such as German, Spanish, French, Italian, and Portuguese. So those have all been added to Scribble here. So it's nice that they keep updating that. Hopefully they'll continue to update this in the future. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the overall performance of this update because it's been pretty good for me. In general, the lag is gone. It's been working okay. It's been stable. So when you go into an app and close out, I haven't experienced any lag whatsoever. The lag I had before is completely gone. So that's a good sign. So performance is much better. It seems very smooth to me, and I'm seeing equal amounts of the same reports on older devices as well. So whether that be the iPhone 6S Plus that I have here, in general, the lag seems to be fixed. Now, this may not be 100%. Someone may still have this issue, but in general, it seems to be resolved. So that's a good sign. Now, as far as any other issues I've had, I haven't had any crashes or anything like that, but quite a few of you have had issues as well. So I want to talk about that. So the first thing is green tint. Now, I showed you that Green Tint is fixed somewhat with Beta 2, mostly when you're booting up and things like that, but there's still some appearances of it. And somehow I missed it in the notes, but the notes even says that iOS and iPadOS 14.5 include an optimization to reduce the appearance of a dim glow that might appear at a reduced brightness level with black backgrounds. So Apple has recognized it and said that they've fixed it. They just haven't called it a Green Tint. I'm sure they'll continue to work on it in the future, though. Also, the flashing or HDR sort of brightness not working properly seems to be resolved for most users as well. Now, we're only on the second beta, so we could see more of these resolved in the future, but right now, that's where we're at with this. Now, there are some issues still in this, for example. So one of them is Siri is not working properly if you have WhatsApp. So some people have said it just won't work if you're using WhatsApp. I don't think I have it installed now, but if you're using WhatsApp, Siri won't work properly. Also, some people have reported random shutoffs and crashes with their phones. So maybe they're in anything from the camera, for example, and it just crashes. And there you saw the lag. So that's the first time I saw any lag whatsoever with the camera. And now it's not doing it when I was swiping it away. Also, quite a few people are saying they have Bluetooth connection issues. So a lot of people were saying Bluetooth is not working properly for them, whether that be AirPods or their car. I did have some issues with my car and attaching it. I haven't had issues with AirPods, but quite a few people are saying they're seeing disconnects, and mostly the issues are with swapping between different devices from your iPhone to your iPad using that automatic switching. It doesn't seem to be working properly. Some other people are saying they have stuttering when scrolling and have it freeze up. I haven't seen that at all in this beta, but some people have seen that, whether that be scrolling in settings or somewhere else. Also, that MagSafe charging animation just isn't there. So that's something that most of us are aware of at this point. And unfortunately, it's not here, but I'm sure they'll bring it back. A few people are having weird Face ID issues. And one person, Liam, said that he had iOS 14.5 Beta 2 and WatchOS 7.4 Beta 2. And he installed it on both of those, had his AirPods in, and then put his phone in his pocket locked, then went to connect his AirPods to his watch, and it unlocked the phone without him doing anything. Since rebooting, it hasn't happened again, but it was a weird bug, so I advised him to report that in feedback. So it seems to be an odd one, but something that is definitely a security concern if it happens over and over. But in general, most people report decent performance, whether that be on the iPhone 11, for example, or the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Most things seem pretty smooth. Not always, not 100%, but it's much better than beta 1, and quite a few people say it's the best beta to date as far as iOS 14. Now let's talk about battery a little bit. We'll go to settings, go down to battery. Battery health on my 12 Pro Max is still at 100%. This is from the day it came out, so it's doing pretty well. Let's go to the last 10 days and let's take a look at the past couple days. So there's a couple that are good, a couple that are not good. So yesterday, 1 hour and 42 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 53 minutes of screen off time, and I used almost 50% of my battery. So that's pretty terrible. However, I only had 50% left by the time I went to bed. So it's kind of strange that that's happening. If I go back the day before, we used a little over 50%, but I had 3 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 6 minutes of screen off time. So this is really hard to understand what's going on as far as battery life. But for me, it seems to be okay in that I have 50% of my battery left when I go to bed. But what the screen on time is telling me just doesn't seem to match up to what I'm experiencing. That could be me, but that's what it seems like. However, I continue to experience poor battery life on my iPad Pro, for example. Some people suggested, like I said before, removing the Apple Pencil, seeing if that helped. I tried it for a day. It made no difference whatsoever, but I thought I'd try it out. And then if we go to battery here, and you can see it was charged yesterday to 80% at 8:37 p.m. And then now we're down to 36%. I used it a little bit today. I used it for 51 minutes yesterday and 2 hours and 17 minutes today. I'm only getting about 3 to 4 hours of screen on time for about 60% of the battery, give or take. So it's not great battery life. I haven't had any other bugs on the iPad whatsoever. Just battery life has been poor. And actually the smoothness on the iPad is incredibly fast. It has the nice ProMotion display, which hopefully we'll see in the next iPhone with iPhone 13. But in general, it just seems nice and fast. No issues with anything whatsoever other than YouTube's own app having a couple odd issues, but I haven't had any issues with anything else on that iPad. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 14.5 14.5 beta 3. Well, we could be on a 2-week cycle still, which would mean we won't see it until March, or we could be on a 1-week cycle. We won't know that until about Monday or Tuesday, so we could see it as soon as the 23rd or 22nd, or as late as March 2nd or so. Sometime around there. So we don't really know yet. And I've been talking about iOS 14.4.1, when to expect that. And generally when Apple stops signing a previous version of iOS, we'll have some sort of release within 2 weeks. However, that hasn't happened this time. So that's changed since iOS 13. So maybe we won't see one since they're fixing the green tint issue in iOS 14.5. So it's really hard to say what Apple's doing with their release schedule. With iOS 14.4, they only released 2 betas. So maybe we'll have a couple betas. Maybe we'll have 7 betas. We don't really know at this point. Apple has sort of gone into something they haven't done before, and it's quite random. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll. So we'll go into YouTube here, and this is pretty incredible since it's only been, well, a day ago or so. So you'll see a day ago, I pushed this poll out and we have 27,000 votes at the time of this video with over 250 comments, 255 comments at this time. And you'll see 17% of you said that it was great. 3% said that it was terrible. 6% said, okay, but some bugs. 62% of you have not updated yet. So you're on iOS 14.4 or older, and 11% are using Android. I didn't specify the version, but if you're a developer, Android 12 is now out as a developer preview as well. So I may cover that in the future, but generally quite a few of you, are usually about 11%, are using Android, which I think it's interesting that it's consistent. So we'll go ahead and sort this by newest first and take a look at a few of these. So Yuri Chandler says, great on my 11 Pro. On my iPad Air 3rd Gen, it has random resprings. Sim King Marone said, still on my iPhone SE 2020, whenever I play Call of Duty, sometimes my screen freezes up and it takes a while for me to turn it off. And can you please share my comment? Now, if it's freezing up, that could be that it's just getting really hot, but you'll get an overheat warning if that's the case. Otherwise, it just may be a bug, whether that be the app or not. I'm not sure which version you're on. Braden Davis says, it's been pretty good for me on my iPhone 12. My banking app still doesn't work, and every now and then I'll have some sort of glitch, but nothing major. The green tint issue has also been fixed, finally. Dan Zimmerelli says, Face ID is hit or miss on my iPhone 12 Pro with this update. Mel Harris says, no problems with my Mini and XR, very smooth and fast. Battery life is good on both. iPad Pro battery life seems to be much better. Used for about 3 hours last night and battery dropped around 25%. Before it would have been down almost 40%. Jury says, iOS 14.5 beta 2, iPhone 12 Pro. So far, so good. It runs much smoother than the first beta. Battery is probably slightly worse. If I quickly switch back and forth between the app library and the home screen, the widgets disappear. I did forget to mention that. A few people said that as well. Sharon Kumar, hopefully I'm saying that properly. Hi, Aaron. Hope you're doing well. Been using iOS 14.5 beta on my iPhone 10. Not sure if this is a software issue. I have been facing an issue with frequent call drops, but overall experience has been good on my iPhone 10 and iPad Pro 11 inch from 2018. Michael King says, so far iPhone 12 Pro Max and iPhone 11 Pro Max is working fine. Battery seems good. And now on the 2020 12.9 inch iPad Pro is working fine with one exception. The battery is not that good. It seems better, but not what it should be. I've used it hard since I'm in Houston and everyone knows what's going on here. I hope you're doing okay, by the way. And also, so it is on the iPhone and iPad at times is the only way I can get online. So that was the way I've tested 14.5 beta 2. It is much better than beta 1 and I'm happy with it other than the battery life on the iPad Pro. Justin says, it's been pretty stable on my iPhone XR. Battery is held up well with a little drain on standby, but other than that, everything is smooth and fast. Only major bug is a lock screen glitch where I couldn't swipe it up at all to get it. The bar was gone and I had to restart my phone to get it back. And so that's it for iOS 14.5 beta 2. Hopefully we see a public release fairly soon, and I'm looking forward to another beta as well. Let me know if you found any other features in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.